come to me?
Yeah.
I want to get washed up. I need rather to be baptized by you.
No.
We do well now to perform with all that God requires. Not a letter, not a stroke will disappear from the law until all that must happen has happened. Therefore, any man who sets aside even the least of the law's demands will have the lowest place in the kingdom of heaven. But he who keeps the law and teaches others, he will have the highest place in the kingdom of heaven. I tell you this, unless you prove yourselves far better men than the Pharisees and the doctors of the law.
Habba, habba, habba!
You shall never enter the kingdom of heaven. But when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth?
I'm glad you brought that up.
Shh! Get around, brothers and sisters! But two men, I said two, went up to the temple to pray. One, a Pharisee. And the other, a tax gatherer.
Ah!
The Pharisee, why, he just stood right on up and prayed thus.
I thank thee, O God, that I'm not like other men, greedy, dishonest, adulterous, or for that matter, like that tax gatherer. I pray twice a week, get back twice a week, and pay taxes on all that I get.
But the other kept his distance and would not even raise his eyes to the good Lord in heaven. I said the good Lord in heaven, child.
Amen, sister.
But feed upon his breast, saying,
oh God, have mercy on me, sinner that I am.
And it was this man, I tell you.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
And not the other, who went and quitted of his sins. For every man who exalts himself shall be humbled, but every man who humbles himself shall be exalted. Shall be exalted. You have learned that thou wast told, do not commit murder. Anyone who commits murder must be brought to judgment. But what I tell you is this. Anyone who nurses anger against his brother must be brought to judgment. And he who sneers at his brother must be brought to court. But he who abuses his brother must answer for it in the fires of hell. Now, what if you are bringing a gift to the altar? And you suddenly remember your brother has a grievance against you.
Hiya!
No! Leave your gift where it is, before the altar. Leave it.
Okay.
First go and make a peace with your brother. Now go and offer your gift. But what if your brother sues you? You better settle with him quickly, or he'll hand you over to the judge, and the judge to the constable, and you'll land in jail. And I tell you, you'll not get out of there till you've paid the last penny.
There once was a king.
Yeah, yeah!
Who decided to settle accounts with the men who served him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
Well, at the outset, there appeared before the master a man whose debt ran into the millions.
Wow!
Into the millions.
Wow!
Well, since the man had no means of paying the money, the master ordered him to be sold to meet the debt with his wife.
Wow!
His child.
Wow!
And everything he had. Well, the man threw himself down at the master's feet and went,
Oh, be patient with me,
he said,
and I will pay you in full.
And so moved with pity was the master that he decided to free the man and remit the debt. And let's hear it for the master!
Yeah!
But no sooner had he gone outside than he met a fellow servant who owed him a few dollars. He gripped him by the throat and said,
pay me what you owe me.
He threw himself down at his fellow servant's feet, begging him, saying,
be patient with me, and I'll pay you.
But he refused, and so was jailed until he could pay the debt.
The other servants saw what had happened and were deeply distressed. They ran and told their master the whole story. Accordingly, he sent for the man. Said to him,
I remember to hold your debt when you appealed to me. Were you not bound to show your fellow servant the same pity I show you?
And so freaking was his quick pocket that he clicked in his shorts and frog in his thick pocket.
What?
And so angry was the master that he condemned the man to torture until he could pay the debt in full.
And that is how my heavenly Father will deal with you, unless you each forgive your brothers from your hearts.
Oh, all right.
If your right hand offends you, I want you to cut it off and fling it away.
Oh, come on.
Now look, it's better for you to lose one part of your body than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell. You've learned that they were told, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But what I tell you is this, never set yourself against a man who wrongs you. So, if someone slaps you on the right cheek, turn and offer you your left.
Jesus Christ!
Slowly I turn, step by step, inch by inch.
Heavenly Father, who sees what is done in secret, he'll what?
reward you!
There was once a rich man who dressed in green and the finest linens.
That's me!
And every day he feasted in the greatest magnificence. And at his gate lay a poor man. His name was Lazarus. He would have been happy to satisfy his hunger with a scratch from the rich man's table. Even the doggy doggies used to lick his open running sores. Well, one day the poor man died. And he was carried away by the angels to be with Abraham. Oh, the rich man also died. And he was buried in Hades, where he was performing. He looked up, but there, far away, was Abraham, with Lazarus close beside him.
Oh, Father Abraham, have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water to cool my tongue. I'm in agony and in fire.
Remember, my child, that all good things fell to you while on earth, and all the bad to Lazarus. Now it is he who has consolation here, and it is you who are in agony. But that ain't all. There's a great chasm fixed between us, and no one from your side who wants to cross it can, and no one from our side who wants to cross it can either.
Then Father, send Lazarus to my father's house, for I have five brothers to warn them that their two men have come to such torment.
They've got Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them. They don't listen to Moses and the prophets. They aren't going to listen to no one, even if someone from the dead should rise.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Either he will love the first and hate the second, or be devoted to the second and think nothing of the first. No man can serve God.
What?
And money.
Money.
Money. Money. Money. Money. Money.
There once was a rich man whose land yielded heavy crops. He debated with himself. Oh, what am I to do, he said. I have not the room to store my produce. Ah, this is what I will do, he said. I will tear down my storehouses and build them bigger. And in them, I will collect all my mitties and mazas and bounties and whips. And then I will say to myself, man, you have plenty of good things laid by you. Enough to last you many years. Take life easy. Eat, drink, enjoy yourself. But then God said to the man, you fool, this very night you must surrender your life. You have made your money. So we'll get it now.
Oh, Therefore I bid you, put away anxious thought about food and clothes to cover your body. Surely the light is more than food, and the body more than clothes.
Her body is more than her clothes. Look, I'll show you.
Consider the lilies of the field. They don't work, they don't spin. And yet I tell you, Solomon in all his glory was not attired like one of these. Well now, if that's how God clothes the grass which is here today, and tomorrow is thrown on the fire, will he not all the more clothe you? How little faith you have! Well, don't go about saying, what am I to eat? What am I to drink?
But what are we to eat?
Set your mind where? God's kingdom and all his justice will come to you as well. So don't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Each day has problems of its own.
Blessed are the poor in spirit.
For theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are they that mourn.
For they shall be comforted.
Blessed are the meek.
For they shall inherit the earth.
Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for justice.
For they shall be filled.
Blessed are the merciful.
For they shall have mercy.
Blessed are the poor in heart.
For they shall see God.
Blessed are the peacemakers.
But they shall be called children of God.
Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake.
For theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are you when men shall revile you, persecute you, and say all manner of evil against you falsely.
Did I ever tell you? I used to read feet.
Feet?
No, that's true. Some people read palms and tea leaves. Look what it says. It says rejoice.
Says Adidas.
Rejoice and be glad. For great is your reward in heaven. When you feel sad or under a curse, your prospects are worse. Your wife is crying, and your olive tree is dying.
Kept on praying and keep me
getting presents when you're gone. Your mood and your growth are broken. Forget that when you
seeds fell on the footpath, where they were trampled on and the birds ate them up.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
Some seeds fell on rock, where after coming up, withered for lack of moisture. Some seeds fell in among weeds, and after coming up, choked. But some seeds fell in among the good soil.
Hey, that's us.
Grew and yielded 100-fold.
If you have ears to hear, then listen, listen, for this is what the parable means. You know what the seed is?
A baby!
No, the seed is the word of God, and that which fell along the footpath represents those that hear the word, but then the devil comes and carries them off, for fear that they should believe and be saved.
What?
And that which fell among rocks. They receive the word with joy when they first hear it, but they have no root, and so in time of testing, they desert. And that which fell among weeds. They receive the word with joy, but they, further growth is impaired by the cares and pleasures of the world.
Oh
no, they bring nothing to fruit. But that which fell among good soil.
Hey, good soil, good soil.
They hear the word with a good and honest heart, and through their perseverance, yield a harvest.
Oh,
wiggle your wrist. Quick march! Ha!
Dancing. He called to one of the servants and asked him what this meant. Your cousin? No. Your brother-in-law? No. Your nephew? No, no. Your brother? Yep, your brother has come back and your father has killed the fatted calf to celebrate. The oldest son was irritated.
Come on!
He was pretty damn mad. He wouldn't go into the house. The father came out and pleaded with him, but he retorted, saying, "You know how I've worked for you all these years and never once disobeyed your orders. But once this son of yours turns up after running through your money with his women, you killed the fatted calf for him." "My boy," said the father, "you are always here with me, and everything I have is yours. And how can we help but celebrate this happy day? For your son was dead and is now alive."
Metaphorically
speaking. Is it what?
Metaphorically speaking.
Oh, thank you. Metaphorically speaking, he was lost and he's found.
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
Well, that is the law and the prophets.
The law and the prophets, the law and the prophets, the law. crucial.